Ho, 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 and welcome to a festive edition of Tackle Talk. Now, if you've got your Christmas list ready, I would say get the Tippex out, because we've got five brand new items of tackle that you may just want to add to the list to send to Santa. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this special.
Right, loads of great products, but first, it's Christmas. Let's start off with the gifts and...
This is embarrassing.
Just for you.
Highly embarrassing, thank you very much. Look at this, look at the wrapping. Did you do this or did your wife do it?
Let's skip over.
It's quite neat, that.
Yeah.
Oh, commercial feeder box bundle from Guru. Oh, wrong way. Best that way. This seems to have a lot of gear in it. Tell me more, Dan.
The feeder box from Guru that everyone knows and loves. They've kitted it out with loads of bits and pieces. We've got a load of hooks in there. We've got a load of method feeders. We've got hybrid feeders. We've got molds. All the little bits and pieces that you all need to go feeder fishing. Notice how when you go into a tackle shop, you go in, you find a few bits of terminal tackle, you walk out with a little carrier bag and it comes to like 30 quid.
Yeah.
Yeah. They all cost an absolute fortune, don't they? So instead, in that box, you have 130 quid's worth of bits and pieces, and they're going to be selling those for $99.99.
Absolutely. So I'm just looking at that list, and there is everything, every size of hybrid, moulds, just so much kit in there.
Well, I noticed that you haven't thought to get me a gift, but that's okay, because I decided to get myself the natural water version, which in fact is even better value for money. This is £150 worth of stuff in this box, and that is going for the same price, $99.99. So should we?
Let's have a look. Let's have a little nosy. I mean, the thing that strikes me for this, there is nothing. Do you know sometimes when you get like a package of something,
yeah,
and there may be things in there which may be that you may not use. All this, if you're a commercial angler,
yeah,
all the feeders, all the hook lengths, everything in there is going to get used, and vice versa if you're on that. And all, as you said, they're not the new products, but everybody uses these tried and tested products, don't they?
Yeah, it's superb. Well, everything's kitted out, ready to go. Like, check mine out here. We've got the little insert tray for hook lengths. That's like a hook length box that goes on the top here. We've got a load of window feeders. We've got some of the little exchange feeders, and we've got some cage window feeders. We've got two of these little boxes to put all your smaller bits and pieces, which they're all included in here. We've got some packs of heli swivels, we've got some line stops, we've got some feeder links, we've got another little lift out tray here, and we've got a load more feeders as well. So there is loads of stuff in here. Oh, as well as the EVA hook length spools, which they're all designed to all fit neatly into this cracking little box.
I was just about to say, the box itself, like that's, you've seen some of my kit, Dan, it's a mess. This is just brilliant, it just puts everything in place. Like I said, moulds, different size of hybrids, methods, stems, it's just everything that you need in there, and it's a great idea. I just think it simplifies everything. As you said yourself, you go in a tackle shop, you think you've picked up a few bits, you get the receipt, and the next thing you know, you're like...
And these are already on their way out to shop. So by the time you watch this video, you'll be able to pick one of these up. So just in time for Christmas.
Fantastic.
If you've got a loved one out there who's the angler in your life, you can pick them up one of these, because trust me, they're worth it.
Absolutely. I still feel terrible I didn't buy you one.
That's okay. As I said, I've bought myself the Matt Godfrey one. You've got the
Steve Ringer one
with the methods and hybrids.
And as it's a present, I get to keep it, right? Maybe not. Okay. Maybe not. Maybe not. I'll stay.
You can keep it.
Right then, let's put these bits and pieces down. So I'm gonna go, I've got a couple of items today, but I'm gonna go with my big party piece to start with. So let's put that out of the way. Pole roller. No, don't worry. This isn't what we're talking about. We're doing a bit of a comparison. So what do you reckon, what do these used to cost? And I mean, and let's look at it as well, right, compared to a modern roller. I mean, it's, you know, There's nothing on a modern roller. It's got no stability.
Would you believe that's actually the larger version, which I can remember there used to be about 40 quid. Did an even smaller version than that. They're pretty Mickey Mouse compared to modern standards.
And you look at, like, you know, you look how much a pole costs. It is so important you have good rollers, because if they fall over or whatever and smash, you know, smash through an expensive section, you've got to have good rollers. If you don't, your pole's in danger, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, enough about that. So what we're saying is that's what we used to get. But now we've got something come onto the market, because one of the big things about new rollers is the cost. But new fish have got these beauties. Ta-da! Look at that. And like magic, we have two pole rollers in front of us.
Magic or just superior editing?
Probably a bit of both.
Hollywood, that.
Come on, it's Christmas. It's Christmas, isn't it? Come on, let's spread the magic.
Tell us about them. What have we got?
So, we have two sizes of pole roller here. First of all, I'm just going to give you the price. The smaller one, which isn't that small, still has extends leg, so it double extends. So you've got a bracket there, so you have one, two. 60 quid.
Yeah.
And then we have the big guy. Now, these rollers of this size, you don't get them for under 100 quid.
Generally not.
Not really, do you?
That's the biggest problem. The rollers have got better, but the prices are pretty extortionate now.
Not now. 85 quid for this. And we've had this up already. That goes over 5 foot when you double extend the legs.
Yeah.
The security, it's stable. It's got a spirit level. The stability is the big thing.
Yeah.
Big legs. That is not going to...
Full nose
not
design, gonna your pole can't blow out of that.
Pole's not going to blow out of that. And the great thing is these are sort of second generation. So they already had a pole roller previously. And what they've done now is they, when they fold up, you can have them flat. Because a lot of the time you don't want the legs up. You know, depending on your banking,
you've got a big high bank to go up.
Exactly.
Over,
yeah, exactly. So you want it to be versatile. And you think when there's a modification which improves the product, and in the day and age where everything's costing more, it's going to cost more. No. Same price as they were before. They were 60 and 85, still at 60 and 85, and been modified. As I said, just really stable. You know, nice soft material. You know, if your pole goes side to side, it's not going to get any damage. And as I said, a pole is people's pride and joy. People can spend up to £5,000. If you're going to spend £5,000, or even if you're going to spend £500 on a pole, whatever it is, you know, it's the party piece in your fishing tackle, isn't it? It's the one thing that costs so much money. You've got our proper rollers. And these, as I said, if it's windy or whatever, or if you're just pushing back and it's not, that isn't going to fall over. You've got the stability.
So let me get that right. That smaller one, 60 quid.
60 quid.
That means you could get two of those for 120 quid.
Yeah.
Most top-end rollers start at around 120
quid. Yeah, they do.
That's excellent value.
And even like I said, two of the big boys, which go over 5 foot.
Yeah.
You're talking quick maths, 170 quid. For two proper massive rollers, I just think they're great. I look at those and I think they're an absolute no-brainer. Yeah. I wouldn't even say like, you know, you'd say on a budget. They're just great rollers. You know, if you want a good roller that's going to keep your pole safe, that's going to give you the versatility. If you're fishing on different banks, you know, flat banks, steep banks, and you need to adjust the legs a lot. I think these are well worth a look. Let's say little things like the hook to put the extra weight on windy days, spirit level to make sure you're right, nicely colour coordinated in the new fish colours. I think absolute winner.
Dude, everything you need from a modern roller at a 1990s prices, really.
They do. I mean,
superb.
I mean, the tiny insignificant thing. The bags, they come in a little bit flimsy, maybe, but you take them out, you put them into a roller bag anyway. I don't carry mine.
Carry
around.
Them loose, to be honest. But if you're paying only 60 quid for a roller, you can't really complain.
No,
about
of course
the bag,
you can't.
Can
of course you can. I couldn't care less. Yeah. I couldn't care less for that sort of price. So, massive winner.
Top marks from New Fish.
Definitely. Now, I don't want to disturb while we talk about something else. So, do a little bit more Houdini. And again.
Yeah, you're getting good at that, aren't you?
I am getting really good at it. Make sure you do a good edit, Dan.
All right, next up, I have a couple of little products from Daiwa.
Okay.
Now, I think usually when you've got your ground bait bucket, you know, most people carry them, it's a little bit of kind of wasted space when you take it to your bag, when you take it to the bank. But they've invented these little cool bags that drop straight into the top of them. So I can see a number of different uses to these. You know, you could either, if you're using it for mixing up your ground bait, why not try bring your dry bags of ground bait in?
Yeah.
In the top of them, it's going to keep them safe and dry whilst you're fishing. Another use, I think a lot of anglers like keep their gear in the shed.
Yeah.
You know, and sorting out their gear and bait the night before is a real pain. Yeah, they try and sort out the bait in the kitchen maybe, you know, and take it in bags.
Yeah.
Well, that way, you only need to take your bucket in your kitchen, you can drop bits and pieces in the top, your bait in bags in the top, you know, with your bags of maggots or pellets or whatever, and you can leave all the rest of your dirty, smelly kit down at the shed, which you'll be getting out in the morning.
Bit of this as well. Yeah. That's a bit different.
Design, yeah.
I was going to say, the metallic on the inside, wipe clean for start with.
Oh yeah, they're cooler bags. They're not just a standard zip-up bag.
Exactly. Yeah, I was going to say that's the thing
in the summer.
Yeah, exactly. I was going to say, like, you know, you like you just said, they double up in that sense. Price?
£20.
Can't argue with that, can you?
Yeah. And great little space-saving device, using up a bit of wasted space in your bucket that you're otherwise going
to
lose.
Just bring you something really that a little bit different to the market. You know, again, like you said, this sort of design, I haven't seen. I can't think of any others that are there. It's not just a copy of something else. It's actually a little bit of a change on it.
There's a couple of bucket liners in the market, which it's designed for like carrying like a load of ground bait or something like that.
Yeah.
But this is the only insulated material, you know, that you can put cool packs in and actually keep your bait cold.
Yeah.
But yet still give you the space underneath for your ground bait, like a dual purpose.
That's great. And it's in the two sizes for whatever you do, but
to fit the two sizes of bucket that I would do.
That sort of price range has got stocking filler written all over it, hasn't it? I like it. I'm really, 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 really impressed with that. And again, it's would they fit into like, let's say, like a Centres bucket? Are they the same sort of sizes?
I think, aren't they?
They're lucky.
I'd have thought the tarp police will come after you if you start doing that.
Yeah, that's true. We'll get done for that, won't we? Wow, I love it. That's nice.
You got something else for me?
I have. So we're going down smaller this time.
Yep.
Time of year, all about edges with bait, isn't it? It's all about when you're trying to eke out a few bites, especially when you're fishing for carp. It's just about trying bits and pieces, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, peg one, our latest bait dies.
Yep.
We have, the pellet transformer liquid. The two we've got here are the chock and mocker. Sounds nice, doesn't it?
Very nice.
And the betaine twist. I think it's just a case of, as I said, if you're fishing a method feeder or you're fishing a pole tap and a few pellets in, why not just do an extra batch and have a bit of colour? And you know, if you can't get a few bites, tap a few in, mould your method up.
Yeah.
All them little edges. Again, under a fiver. I always say this. Having these products in your bag, just think, what can I do to get an extra bite?
Yeah.
You know, you go to places, you look at places like when they're fishing, like Boddington, for example, they're after one or two fish in the middle of winter. And these are the little things that could give you that edge. So
it's
why not have them?
Pellets as well. Everybody turns up with exactly the same pellets. They're all feeding little and often. What makes your pellets stand out?
So exactly.
Do they work though?
Yes.
Can you give us a demonstration?
Watch this. Watch what will happen now. So hard pellets, hard 2mm micros. I haven't done anything with them. What I think, and when we've done it, is a little bit of water to start with at the mixing process.
Yeah.
We'll go with the green one.
That was sure.
Don't need much in there at all.
Whoa.
Little dribble.
You've already got it all over your hands.
A little dribble.
Incredible Hulk fingers.
Grab the lid. There we go. Starts to take the colour. I mean, we've only just started. Starts to take the colour on. As I said,
it's already going.
And the thing is, they're not softened. We haven't put the water in. But they will turn the colour. And it's just having an edge. And that's what it's all about. And I think for a fiver, it's worth having these things in there. And got a scent as well. That's it. Got a scent. So you're getting double bubble for it. And if you're like Dan and you just want to use a thimble every time, then that'll last you all winter. But if you're a bit more generous like me, then it might last you half a winter.
I'll show you a picture of these on camera in a minute. They are going to be absolutely luminous, the amount you put on them. That's
what I'm after. I want to stand out, don't I? Little edge, worth getting them. Getting them in your, put it in your bag. Might just get you a few more bites when you're struggling.
Yeah, we'll do four different flavours of these. Superb.
Away you go.
Shall I show you my next product?
Let's go.
Right, you may remember from the last video, Midwater. We had like the smaller bin. They also do side tray bags.
This looks stable. This looks big and ready.
Superb, isn't it?
Yes.
Like most side trays out there, like we're kind of getting to the point where they don't fit generally into your carry-all anymore. People don't even carry a traditional carry-all with a keep net and that in it. You know, your keep nets are carried in like a big kind of EVA stink bag. You carry like a cool bag as like a carry-all or something like that. Transporting side trays is a bit of a pain.
Mm, so absolutely.
They do these bags. They're starting in price at £30 for just like the standard one. This is one of the larger sizes they do. You've got the options of an extra pocket on the side or the deluxe padded version. So they go from £30 up to £50. And they'll also make them to any size of side tray you want.
They look really well made. That looks really durable. Because like you've said, I'm guessing your side tray's in there now.
Well, as standard.
But it's like you've said, go back 10 years or even further when we used to sit on a Shakespeare box. We didn't have that, did we?
No.
Is that, that's where fishing's at. Everyone's got one of them. And if you said transporting that, we've got luggage for it. We've got luggage for everything. You know how we were talking earlier about pole roller bags? This seems to be one of the things that generally...
We could fit two of those in there. Like you see the size of the large Preston hooded. This bag's perfect size for that. So as standard, you'll fit two proper size side trays on it. Because I'm the kind of guy who carries a lot
everything.
Of gear. Well, it's the kind of match fishing that I do. Sometimes I'm wading out into water. So you need lots of side trays to carry all your bait and everything. There's no good running out of casters and wading back to the bank again, splashing around, scaring all your fish off. So it's in the side pocket there. Got enough room for my smaller side tray. Fit a bucket loop in there. And even, my pole sock bits and pieces as well. Yeah. All fits. Oh yeah. And me roost as well, which
I mean you've got that's the kitchen sink.
I understand that's a little bit extreme for most people.
They do
smaller ones. You know, this is like the biggest version with the extra side pocket on it. But let's say you've just got a big awkward side tray, it's a pain in the ass to carry, always gets in the way, snags up when you're getting it in and out of the car. From £30, you can get a purpose-built bag for it.
But you can get anything else in there as well. You know, like you said, that material, that feels, heavy duty. You know, as in, like, that's not going to rip. The zips look good.
Oh, the zips are absolutely...
It looks really, really impressive.
I've seen a lot of luggage, but the zips on this is absolutely fantastic. Like, you're used to the fact that when the zip gets a little bit wet, it gets cold, you haven't got the top fully shut properly. You start pulling on the zip, it binds up, and you think, am I going to snag the material inside? Is it going to bind up?
Yeah.
No, this zip just laughs at that. Look at the size of the thing. You just get your kit half in, pull it, and it just goes.
Good price point
really,
as well.
Really, really well made.
Good price point when you look at it. So you look at all that kit you took out of there. That has to be well made to, not to buckle, not to rip.
Yeah, yeah.
How long have you had it?
Oh, I've had it about 3 or 4 weeks now.
It did look quite clean. compared to some of your kit, I did think it was quite new.
It's been raining all the time. I've been washing all the mud off. You say about strength, Midwater's original trade, the way they started out, it was making carry-on baggage for flights in aircraft and aircraft holds, and you think, well, if aircraft baggage handlers can't damage their bags, then anglers with their bits and pieces trying to be careful with their expensive gear, they're not going to do it.
Yeah, this is nothing for them, is it? If that's where they started, then carrying a bit of fishing tackle, they've got this covered, haven't they? Well, there we go. I reckon people are at home there with the Tipex getting their Santa list. I reckon they put a few of these bits and pieces on.
I'd hope so. Email the link to your wife or your girlfriend. Hint that you should be doing a little bit more feeder fishing and check out those Guru feeder boxes. I really, really like that. Load of gear, all the expensive bits and pieces all in one box like that.
Do what I did, get someone to get it as a Christmas present, eh?
Yeah.
That's what you should do. That's it, exactly. But as always, guys, hope you've enjoyed it. Have a fabulous Christmas. Hope you get out of the bank and wet a line. And we'll see you again in the new year with more Tackle Talk.
See you in the new year, guys.
Okay.
That look alright?
Yeah.
Sensible. Right, you ready?
Yeah, you look a bit daft, but...
Yeah, I know, but that's fine.
Nice hat.